Boys, that's a song that was written by primarily by Apollo, and I added that opening riff, and I mean it's one of the standout tracks of the album in my opinion. It's the only track that would kind of like remind of the older of the oldest albums sound. It's a bit more commercial hard rock type of song, but at the same time it's got a nice vibe to it, and I really like it. Edge of a Dream, right. That is a pretty unusual ballad for us. To be honest, when the guys first presented it to me, I was against it. Because I didn't want to have a piano song on the album. But I gave it a couple of listens and I actually agreed that this is actually a pretty killer song and we should have it on the album. And while listening to it, I actually said to Bob, you know, it would be great if we had actually some cellos on top of that song, and even better if we actually had Apocalyptica play on it. And he said, wow, great. But we actually had no connection to the guys or anything. So I said, well, let's ask him, we got nothing to lose. And our manager just emailed the track to their manager, said, hey, listen, we're firing, we would love to have you guys on the track. And a few days later, we heard back from them that they really liked it. And we didn't expect it, and but I think this collaboration came out very nice. It really lifts the song. Destiny. That is also probably another track that is just... It starts out as a, you would think, maybe like a typical Firewind hard rock song with a melodic riff, but when it comes to the chorus, it just changes complete mood. It's almost has like a punk rock feel. Long Gone Tomorrow. Okay, yeah, that's a pretty heavy rock track, and I like how it starts with a heavy riff in the beginning. It grooves, and then it comes into another heavier part of it. And it's influenced, you know, it's got a lot of hard rock influences, and it's got a lot of, you know, the Black Sabbath vibe on it. And I really like what Apollo's doing with his vocals on that. There's a lot of multi-layers of vocals on the chorus. And it's a track that I would actually be very excited to play live. No Heroes, No Sinners. It's a song. It's got a different kind of vibe. Actually, I don't know. It's a perfect way to close a record, I think. It has a lot of acoustic guitars in it. Actually, I recorded 6 and 12 string guitars, acoustic guitars, and Apollo's vocal lines are fantastic. We actually, it's basically two songs that came into one because Apollo had these lyrics and these lines for another song, which was, the music was not as good, so he tried to sing those lines over this demo that I had, and it just was a perfect match, and we didn't really need to do any extra work on that. You know, it's one of those times where you just like, wow, you put two separate songs together, two different vibes, and it becomes one right away. And I think it's a really good way to close the album, because it has a it's a very melodic song, but also has the heavy parts in there and a killer solo. We are the ones.